So, you have to learn about the laws of exponents, huh? Well, let's remix one of your favorite songs with a little bit of math, and let's have some fun.
These are the laws of exponents. Do you know them? They are really super helpful in your math life. Yes, they're so tight. Raise the number to a power. The laws of exponents. If you know them, then you'll think math is a breeze in your real life. Yeah, you know right. Raise a number to a power.
So the first thing to know about an exponent is it is called a power, a little raised number that tells you how many times to write the base as a factor instead of seeing a number times a number times a number times a number times a number. An example is if you see a big 2 followed by a small raised 5, it means 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, which is equal to 32. That was really fast. A lot of information that was packed in it. I said hashtag facts. But let's get back to business and the point of the laws of exponents. Do you know them? They are really super helpful in your math life. Yes, they're so tight. Raise the number to a power. The laws of exponents. If you know them, then you'll think math is a breeze in your real life. Yeah, you know right. Raise the number to a power.
8 to the first means write A once. Write A once, write A only once. A to the nth times A to the nth equals A to the m plus nth power. Simply stated, it means A times dot 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 times A m plus n times. And if you have the same base, then you're multiplying. Add the exponents and evaluate. A to the nth times A to the zeroth equals A to the m plus zeroth equals A to the nth. A to the 0 equals 1. I said A to the 0 equals 1.
These are the laws of exponents. Do you know them? They are really super helpful in your math life. Yes, you're so tight. Raise the number to a power. The laws of exponents. If you know them, then you'll think math is a breeze in your real life. Yeah, you know right. Raise the number to a power.
A to the nth divided by A to the nth equals A to the m minus nth power. That means 2 to the 5th divided by 2 to the 1st equals 2 to the 5 minus 1st,
which equals 2 to the 4th, which equals 16. A couple more laws. A times B raised to the nth equals A to the nth times B to the nth. So each factor gets raised to the nth power. A to the bth times C to the dth raised to the nth power equals A to the B times nth times C to the D times nth. And what if you end up with a negative? What do you do? A to the negative nth equals 1 over A to the nth. It's the reciprocal. Now you understand me too. I mean, squared.